looking inside this garbage disposal. There's a whole section in there that's been ground away. These things that beat the food around, they look clean as a whistle. As we come around, there's another whole section that's tore out. Again, this looks pretty good. It's this piece here that they're mounted on that rots all to hell. And there's a hole drilled in here, and this is like where a scale has broken off. And it's just a lot of pitting in there. This is, you can see daylight here. This is what goes to the drain. But this all seems to be eroded away. Now when this fails, water goes out the bottom, leaks all underneath the kitchen cabinet, and trips the GFI unit that I had connected to this. This is a Badger 5 InSinkErator, half horsepower, 2-year warranty. It makes it 2 years. This is the second one to fail in 14 years. I just got through installing my third unit. And when it fails, water comes right out through the bottom. They've got some funny security type bolts on here. I'm going to see if I can get those out of there and take this thing apart and see what it looks like on the inside. Continuing the failure analysis of the InSinkErator Badger 5, half horsepower, heavy duty motor. It might be a heavy duty motor, but there's nothing heavy duty about this garbage disposal. Emerson Electric, Racine, Wisconsin. No place on here were they proud enough to say where this was made. The last one I bought says that it's made in the United States. If this is made in the U.S., shame on us. You finally get this thing apart, that's your motor. And attached to the motor shaft is this plate. This plate spins with this motor shaft. These things flail around and keep things distributed to the outside edge. And this originally appears to have had some sort of teeth on this plate. So this thing is turning in here and grinding up your food between the teeth on this and these little serrations, or what do you want to call them, on this outside of this housing. And this housing is plastic. This bottom part is shoved up in here with some sort of a mastic. It's very sticky. They glue that in there, and then there's an O-ring that seals between this unit and the edge of this right up in here. And that seals pretty well until the unit fails, and then water goes everywhere. But anyway, this thing started making noise like an air raid siren a couple of months ago. And I looked inside and I could see bits and pieces of this metal had disappeared. And that's what probably where the noise was coming from. It quieted down again after a while. And then last weekend it failed altogether. Now this thing is nothing but a bunch of rust. It is pretty much deteriorated. There's still some material here, but not much. The sad part is the bottom of this unit. It's just a piece of galvanized and not very heavy. And it has failed completely. You can see it has failed all the way around here. And when it let go all at once. And that's where all the water was going underneath the kitchen cabinets. When I was growing up, I can't ever remember anybody having to replace a garbage disposal. They lasted a long time. I built my house 14 years ago. This was the second unit. Just installed the third unit last weekend. And we'll see if it holds up any better. But looking at this, I doubt it. These are just not made worth a damn. That's way too thin a material to be in something that gets the abuse of a garbage disposal. And this unit has never had any bones or potato peelings and stuff like that going through it. All this gets is kitchen waste, like when you're cleaning up your dishes and stuff like that. Totally unacceptable as far as I'm concerned.